Hi, Ritvik says, hello sir, I have asked you a question, what is the right time to start an internship? Yes, Ritvik, this is one question which I thought about a lot, even while brushing my teeth today morning, having the bath, every time I was thinking about the question. The right time to start an internship is in your first year. Now, how would you get an internship in your first year? You don't know anything. So the idea to get an internship in first year is to, the thing which I said just now, ask everyone around you, like my uncle, my mama, Satyam. He just called me a few days back and he said, I saw your YouTube video and I know you, now I know you know web development. So can you make a website for me? He runs an NGO and he wants a website for it. I said, sure, give it to me. So this is how you do. You show people that you are working on something. You show people that you are learning something. And then people will come to you, or you go to people saying that, you know, I have a 1 month or 2 month break. Can I make something for you? Can I make a YouTube video for you? Can I make a, can I teach you how to code? Can I make a website for you? Do anything, and that's your internship. Internship means creating value. The moment you learn how to create value, you are gold. And then once you have some experience in first year, and then in second year, third year, you will get into a good company, in a very good startup, in a very good company, maybe in Microsoft, in Google, anywhere. But you need to learn to create value for that. And the way to create value is you need to talk to people and ask them for help. Ask them whether I can help. If you do not have a project currently, ping on Meta Startup group and say that, you know, I know web development. I want to do something, or I have a 2 month break. Does anybody need a web developer? Oh, hi. People will jump on you. They'll take you. They will give you money for that. So the answer is, first year, create value, ask your friends, ask everyone around your family, and see if you can find an internship. If you cannot find an internship, ask the community. Go and post on Reddit saying, hey, I know web development. Does anybody want a website? And see how people jump on you. Just do that, okay? Samajh mein aayega tumko ki how easy it is to get internship. Please don't ping people on LinkedIn saying, I need an internship. Find your internship yourself in first year and second year. Third year, people will ping you. I think you have done an awesome job. Ritvik, do you want to work for my company? Can I give you a call right now? And people will call you. Let people come to you. You don't need to go to people. Create the value first. I want to pursue a career in Cisco CCI security. Please give your suggestions. Cisco CCI security is not a great job. Is my true feeling. Why? Because you do not make a lot of money. Why you do not make a lot of money? Because everybody and anybody can go through the dumps and answer the questions and get the certification. When the bar to get a certification is low, everybody gets it, and then you do not have the leverage. So this world, right? Ye dunya hai na dunya. This dunya works on leverage. Leverage means, if you are offering something which others do not have, but they want, they will pay you money. Cisco CCI security, everybody has. There are less people who want it. So, not good money. Good money, not good money. So, I would say do coding more. Learn about security if you're interested. I know about security. A lot of people know about security who are working on code, but don't pursue that as a career, at least in India. If you really want to do security, go to US. They have some really good courses there. Do your master's there, and then we are talking. Is a UX developer the same as front-end developer? Kind of yes, kind of no. When you're working in a small company, there are no barriers. You are everything. You are full stack developer, you are UX designer, you are UX developer, everything. When you work in a big company, like say in Microsoft, there is a UX developer who does only HTML and CSS. There is a front end developer who does only JavaScript. There is a designer who does only designing, Photoshop, Sketch. There is a back end developer. Even in back end developer, there are different teams. So it depends on your company, but mostly you should know about it, all of it.